All right, let's take a look at what's making headlines across the world now. And Scotland's former First Minister, Nicola Sturgeon, has been arrested as part of an ongoing investigation into party finances.
Let's go live to Europe correspondent Carrie-Anne Greenbank now. Carrie, the former leader has been released without charge.
Morning, Sarah. Well, she has. So Nicola Sturgeon has been released without charge after being arrested hours earlier, something that she said she found as both a shock and deeply distressing. She was being questioned by detectives as part of a two-year investigation into the Scottish National Party's finances, specifically what happened to more than $1 million of donations that had been donated by independence activists. That money was meant to be earmarked for a second independence vote. Nicola Sturgeon had been Scotland's first minister for 9 years until she abruptly announced her resignation in February. But her arrest is the latest in this ongoing scandal. The party's treasurer had previously been arrested, along with its former chief executive, who was also Nicola Sturgeon's husband. Both of those men were released without charge as well. As for Nicola Sturgeon, after her release, she said that she is beyond doubt, direct quote, she is beyond doubt that she is innocent of any wrongdoing. But the saga continues, Sarah.
All right, thank you, Carrie-Anne. A major highway in the United States has collapsed after a tanker caught fire, the intense heat cracking the concrete above.
Wow. US correspondent Jonathan Kersley is following the story. Jono, good morning. Remarkably, no one was hurt.
Yeah, this is just extraordinary. Nobody injured or killed in this freeway collapse. And the images that are coming out of Philadelphia and Pennsylvania are just extraordinary. There you can see that is the northbound section of the I-95 overpass that is heading north from Philadelphia in Pennsylvania. It collapsed round about 6 o'clock local time this morning. So sort of 9 hours or so ago, almost 10 hours or so ago now. And authorities right now are trying to deal with the sort of flow on effects from this. The collapse and the fires sent plumes of smoke billowing into the air. It was a tanker carrying thousands of litres of fuel that crashed and erupted into flames. Firefighters had to deal with that fire first before then dealing with what came afterwards, and that was the overpass collapsing, because for around about 20 minutes or so there were still cars going over that section of the freeway, even as that fire continued to burn and that smoke continued to go into the air. Now there is concern about runoff from that fuel going into the drain network and then into the Delaware River around there. Authorities say that this is going to take many, many weeks now in order to repair. What you've got is a section of the road that is completely buckled. It has collapsed and now it is going to need repair. But right now, authorities also grateful that no human loss of life occurred.
Absolutely, Jono. Thank you. Three British tourists are this morning missing after a fire on board a boat off Egypt's Red Sea coastline. A further 12 British tourists were rescued from the vessel, which had been out on a scuba dive cruise. Initial examinations had found an electrical short circuit in the engine caused the fire.
Donald Trump's former Attorney General says the evidence against the former president in the classified documents case is very damning. William Barr, who has become increasingly critical of his ex-boss, fired this message this morning.
If even half of it is true, then he's toast. I mean, it's a very detailed indictment, and it's very, very damning. And this idea of presenting Trump as a victim here, a victim of a witch hunt, is ridiculous.
Sounds very definitive, doesn't it? Donald Trump will face 37 counts in a Miami court on Wednesday.